Today we're going to talk about how to install a dual extruder. Most of the time it's called a Cyclops, but I have a variant that says NF on it. Now, I'm going to explain each one of these parts separately, but first I'm going to explain where things go. We have our stepper drivers over here. We have our ramps 1.4 connected to our Arduino Mega. And then, of course, we have our cables that run to the extruder and a fan on the back side of the extruder. So in a moment, I'm going to show you the steppers, and then I'll talk about the extruder, and then I'll show you how to connect everything together. Okay, to start with, we have two different types of steppers that I'm going to use. I'm going to connect the regular X, Y, and Zs with the A4988s. And then I'm going to connect the extruders with the DRB8825s. And then the ports that they go in, we have our X, our Y, and our Z. Then we have extruder 0 and extruder 1. So it's extruder 1 and extruder 2. So one of the things that we have to keep in mind is that we need to have jumpers on all three of our pins. I left them off in this case for a moment so you could see, but I'm going to place these back on in a moment so that we can finish the configuration. So in a second, I'll explain the steppers to you in greater detail. Okay, this is the top side of the A4988. We have a trim pod here. Then we have our cooling aluminum that draws or wicks away the heat on the chip. And then if you look real close on yours, on the underside we'll have some pin names. So I'm going to flip it over and show you in just a moment. Okay, as you can see, the underside here, we have an enable written here that is associated with this pin right here. Then we have our ground pin up here, and then we have our direction pin over here. So I'm going to show you the other chip and explain it as well. Okay, here's the top side of the DRB8825. We have a trim pod, and then we have our cooling fins for our chip. And in a moment, I'll show you the underside so we can see the actual pins and how they're associated. Okay, here's the underside of the DRB8825. As you can see, we have our ground pin here, we have our direction pin, and then we have our enable pin. Now keep in mind, these are going to be used for lining them up on the ramps 1.4, and I'll show you how they line up in just a moment. Okay, we're looking at the Z stepper driver port. There are no pins on here yet. I'm going to place these on before I actually place on the stepper driver. But here's the direction pin where it's associated with. We have our ground pin, and then on the other side, we have our enable pin over in here. So that's how we're going to line up our chips based on the pins for our stepper boards. So in a moment, I'll show you how they're connected. Okay, before we start connecting the jumpers, I just want to show you that the pins are empty still, so I'm going to put these on. This gives us the highest degree of step when we have them all on the ramps board and jumped. There we go. So the first one is going to be our A4988. So we have to figure out where the enable pin is, which is over here. And we know that the enable pin is over in here for the Z axis. So we're going to place that over there, and we're going to apply a little bit of pressure. And now it's in place. So now we're going to do the next one exactly the same way. So we want to keep the potentiometer pointing in the same direction as the A4988 that we just placed on there. And we're going to apply a little bit of pressure, and that one's in place. And then finally, last one. for the x-axis. So the next thing that we want to do is we want to put the DRV 8825 on for E0. So we have to flip it over, check to find where the enable pin is, which is over here. So we're going to rotate it back over. Notice the potentiometer is in the opposite direction of the A4988. And we're going to place that down. And then we're going to do the same for the second extruder. And in a moment, I'm going to show you how to set up the extruder for the dual extruder. So here's our dual extruder. It takes two inputs from stepper drivers. So you have your extruder 1 and your extruder 2, or the opposite, depending upon how you connect it. And it's going to have a tube that connects into here from your stepper motor. So the other thing that we have to keep in mind is that we have our heater right here, and our thermistor right here to tell temperature, and then we have our extruder head. On the back side, we have our fan. So in a moment, I'm going to show you how to connect this to the RAMPS 1.4. Okay, to install the dual port extruder, or Cyclops, we need to know what our connections are going to be. So we have D10, D9, and D8. We're going to use the configuration for the ramps of extruder, fan, bed. So it's extruder, fan, and then bed. But we're going to leave off the bed portion. So I'll show you how to connect this. So we're going to take the heater cartridges wires, and we're going to connect them to our port right here. Now, plus and minus doesn't matter for this because it is not required for the actual heating cartridge. So there we go. Now for the fan, what we need to do, we do have to pay attention. So we're going to do plus for voltage, and we're going to do negative for ground. And there we go. So the last piece that we have to do is we have to hook up the thermistor. So our thermistors are located over here. So we have T0, T1, and T2. Now the plus and minus doesn't matter. So we're doing T0 because that's what we're working with. So we're going to slide these DuPont connectors on that I connected to make it easier. And then in a moment, I'm going to show you how to program it. So I'm going to connect the serial USB, which I'll show you in just a second, which is right here. So the big side goes to the underside over here for the USB serial. So you slide that in, and then the other side goes to your computer, so you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you how to program it in Marlin. Okay, first thing we want to do is open up Marlin-Bugfix-1.1.9. Then we want to go into the Marlin subfolder. Then we want to go to boards. .h and open that up. And what we're going to search on is ramps. And what we have down here are the types of ramps boards. So this is the one that we're going to be using. It's the default in the Marlin driver. So I'm just going to copy it so you can see. Then I'm going to close out of that, and I'm going to press M on the keyboard and open up the Marlin.ino. Now I'm going to select the configuration.h tab, and I'm going to search on motherboard to verify that we have the right one. And as you can see, it's exactly the same as what we're looking for in boards.h, so we're good there. So the next thing we want to do is we want to find extruders, and because we have two extruders, we're going to change the 1 to a 2. And then our filament diameter in this case is probably going to be 1.75. And then a little bit further down, we have define single nozzle. So we're going to say that we're only using one nozzle. So we're going to remove the comment. And that's all you have to do to set up dual extruders. But now I'm going to show you what you do for the other possible parts of the configuration that you might run into. So I'm going to scroll down to thermal settings. Now down here we have outlined our settings that we're going to use for thermistors. In this case, I'm going to use the default setting. So down here, they have temperature sensor 1, which is going to be our temperature sensor inside our extruder. So it's set to 1, so we're going to leave it as default. If you know what yours is named, then you can use the number for that above. And then at the moment, we're not using a heat bed, so we're not going to worry about that. So the next thing I want to show you is the stepper drivers. So I'm going to search on A4988. And as you can see, they've come up with some new changes to the firmware. Now, if you don't change anything in here, it's going to be default A4988. But seeing how we're using a mix of steppers, I'm going to remove the comments for the X type driver. I'm going to remove the comments for the Y type driver and the Z type driver for A4988. And then down below, we have the two extruders that we're going to be using. So I'm going to remove the comments for those. And because they're a different stepper, we need to find what stepper type that is. So over here we have DRV8825, so I'm going to copy that. And I'm going to go down here and replace the A4988 with that and do the same for the other extruder. And then what we need to do is find max steps. And what we have here is default access steps per unit is what we're looking for. So we have our X, which is the 80 in this case, the Y, which is 80 for our Y stepper, and then our Z is 4000. These are default settings, but because we're using a DRV8825 for our E stepper or extruder, we're going to have to double the value to 1000. And then up here, if you have different types of extruders, which I don't recommend for this part, this is how you would actually set them up. So the next thing that we want to do is make sure that thermal runaway is set correctly. So we have thermal runaway protection. The reason that we want to make sure it's enabled is so that we can prevent it from overheating. So as you can see right here, the thermal hot end protection is enabled by default for all extruders and for the heat beds. So we're going to leave that alone. And then in order to load it, we're going to go to tools. We're going to make sure that we have the right board selected, which we do. It's the Mega 2560 for the chipset. Next thing we want to do is we want to select our COM port, which is COM port 15 in this case. And then we're going to press the upload button, which will compile and upload our changes from the Marlin firmware for configuration.h. In a moment, I'm going to show you how to test the dual extruder in Pronterface.
Okay, as you can see, I've hooked up a couple of steppers. So I have an X, Y, E0, and E1. I have the extruder, and then I hooked up the power while you weren't looking, as well as it's unplugged. So I'm going to power this up. So remember to keep your hands away from the board after it's energized. because now this area is dangerous with power. So in a moment, I'm going to show you in Pronterface how to test it. Okay, the first thing we want to do is we want to open up Pronterface. We want to connect to the device. And as you can see, we only have one extruder at the moment, so we need two. So in order to get a second one, what we're going to do is go to Settings, Options. We're going to click on where it says extruder count, and we're going to say that it's instead of one, two, and press OK. Then we're going to close out of Pronterface and reopen it. We're going to reconnect, and as you can see, we have total number of tools of zero here, but if we click again, we have a second one. So the first thing we want to do is we want to test the fan to see if it's working. So we're going to type M106P0S200 and see what happens. So as you can see, the fan's running. So to turn it off, what we're going to do in this case is we're going to say the S is now zero, so S0, and press enter. There is another G code for this, but for now I'm just going to show you this. Next thing I want to do is I want to show you the actual steppers work. So we're going to have to type M302. Then we're going to say P0 for the actual thermistor temperature. So it's the first thermistor. And we're going to say that the temperature now is going to be a max in order to get stepping of 30 degrees Celsius. And we're going to press enter. So now we can do cold extrusion because it's usually 170 degrees Celsius by default. So the next thing I want to do is set it so that it's on for the extruder. So it's going to go up to 35 degrees Celsius because that's what I've set the default for. And in order to move the extruder for the first extruder, we're set to zero. So I'm going to press the extrude button and let you see what happens. Now I'm going to do it on the other extruder. Okay, and to turn off the fan, we've already showed you that, so I'm going to show you how to turn off the extruder. So we're going to press the off button here to do the simple way. And if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.